Hello everyone and welcome to a random gameplay of Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg, an excellent game that I haven't played for years. I don't know why I didn't, but I didn't, and yeah, I would like to continue. I'm the rebellious gamer that does not save his game, at least in random gameplay videos. So here we go, we've got ourselves an intro. The birdies are playing, they're having a great time at the beach. Oh, until the crows arrive. That looks really bad. Crows versus chickens, the greatest rivalry in the history of gaming. And here's our main character. He's late for an important date. Hey, don't complain, I made it. Uh-oh. Oh no! Evil crows! Oh, that's violent against crows. Instant growth! That would probably cause some massive growing pains if you ask me. Loading screen. Doesn't even... Oh, just ruins the whole flow no matter what. This game isn't even immune to the loading screen. Alright, so here we go. That was pretty much the game storyline. You got the jump button and you can't really do much of anything at this moment. For some reason it's B to press through the text. It's kind of odd like that, so press B to switch, go through the text. Oh, that is not good. So those crows apparently can block out the light of day with their cloud of doom. Those must be some pretty powerful magical crows. Sounds good, I think I'll be able to do that. Ooh, I definitely want that chicken suit. Awesome, now let's get back to the game. So, as I said, you can't really do anything at this moment until you get that chicken suit. And yeah, it's coming up very shortly here, so don't worry about it. In fact, it's up to the right, if I recall. I could be wrong though. What? Did you just say you can't play outside anymore? You're outside right now. What? So anyway, up here. And right here is the legendary chicken suit! Yeah, I was hidden really well, huh? And this is the gimmick of the game. It is a 3D platformer, but the gimmick is that you get to control eggs with various moves, and you can also hatch certain critters out of eggs, which will help you progress through certain areas. You'll see as I keep going. It's the crow version of Kamek! Hey, come back here! Fight me like a crow! Oh, and if you jump in the water, I believe you'll die instantly. But anyway, let's get to the egg controls. When you walk up to an egg, you'll automatically grab it. If you stop, it'll stop with it and then let go of it and stuff like that. If you jump and then jump again in midair, you'll do that. If you press B in there, you'll slam it. If you run while pressing the B button, you can do like a boomerang egg attack, which is pretty handy for certain things. I'm not going to be clearing out every single thingy in this area. You can also blow things up with your egg, but this camera is not working very well, so I'm going to switch it over with the C-stick. There we go. What do you have to say to me, chickadee? Chickadoo? Chirpy chirp? I was just explaining that. Were you not watching the video? Duh! Perhaps I should have talked to the chickadee first before I did my explanation, because she is going to do it for me. Anyway, I'm gonna go flatten some enemies. Literally. And you can get fruit from the enemies inside these bubbles and stuff like that. You'll notice that little gauge at the bottom right corner there is filling up as I collect the fruits. That is important. And let me grab... You know what? I'm gonna switch eggs. I'm gonna grab this one instead, because that one doesn't usually have anything but food and stuff like that in it. And it also seems like your egg grows faster when you collect items faster, like these fruit bubbles and stuff like that, the power-ups and whatnot. It's just a little observation. I'm not sure if it's true or not. It might be based on the size of the fruit inside the bubble. And over here, well, I'll talk to you for... I didn't mean to flatten you, I'm so sorry. That's why I grabbed the orange and red egg there, because it's got a different critter inside of it than the other one. The other blue and white spotted one just usually contains other stuff other than critters, and I'd like to show you one of the critters. And as I said, the gimmick of the game is the egg, so it's very important that you have an egg with you at all times. And what? Let me jump into the egg. Don't tell me I didn't jump into the egg. And what is this glowy thingy? Yep, need an egg for that. Needless to say, the first stage of the game is a tutorial stage of sorts, just getting you used to things. Man, this egg is very strong. What do you have to say? Wait, did I talk? Oh, I went... Oh, the camera must have flipped around on me. I got confused. Anyway, now you want to go back this way. And that gate that was once closed over there is now open. I remember that much about the game. What? Didn't you see the gate open? You are a terrible guard chicken. Or a terrible guard chick. Alright, now when your egg gets full and is flashing, which will be soon, there's also these things to collect in the levels as well. These are called chick coins. The egg of the blue hedgehog. Yeah, this is a game made by Sega, so it's got a few references to Sonic. Now, once the egg is full and glowing like this, press the R button. And now we have a critter! This is Cypher! And what can you do with a critter? Well, if you press the... Oh, right, you gotta touch him first. Alright, you gotta grab an egg first. Come on with me. Now, once you... Wait, actually, I forgot how to activate ye ol' powers. X, Y... Ah, there we go. It is the X button. And you can, of course, use that to demolish enemies as well as solve puzzles. Okay! Just had to get the hang of that once again. Well, I should say, had to find the right button once again. I was making a walkthrough on it or something like that. I'd of course do like a couple practice runs through a stage and whatnot. But I know you guys like to see me flail around every once in a while, so eh. So I thought I would do this one mostly untamed, so to speak, and leave all the rough edges in. Yeah, and that's the technique that I said a little bit earlier. Boop! And this is an egg switch. You gotta do the same move to hit that thing. I bet you that chickadee will tell me exactly what I just told you. Chirp, chirp! Oh, it's called a driver switch. Yep, pretty much. Alright, back down we go. Oh! And instinctively, I just pressed the L button to center the camera. That works just like Zelda. I should have used that earlier. Ooh. Oh, come on! Didn't you? It's open! I'm going to take out my frustrations on these critters. And fill up my egg. And there's a lot of critters to talk to. Well, chickens. Well, more like chicks. So that's a cat, crow, thing. Woo! These things are similar to the barrel cannons in Donkey Kong Country. And try and get that coin on the right side. Oh, poopers. I am shamed. I wonder if I'll be able to go back up there and get that. Press the R button to shimmy yourself around. No! I want to get the coin! No! I can't control myself to get back up there easily. There's probably some way to get that back from down there if you sort of cheese the physics a little bit. Anyway, we're coming up to the end of the level, actually, and I've been messing around a whole lot. What is on the inside of this egg? Cat pendant? I don't remember those or something. What the heck was that? Alright, you come with me. We got a battle to do. I probably should have grabbed an egg before I came up here, but whatever, there will be one around here. Or I could just use my battling buddy there. Sounds good! Oops, wrong button. One hit kill! Quite literally, in fact. Alright, let's hatch this elder. Boop. Yeah, so we gotta power it up with ye ol' fruit. It's good for eggs, apparently. Not sure how an egg manages to absorb the fruit, but there we go. I like how you can see like the yolk on the inside. And this is why I left the fruit along this area a little bit earlier, because I was like, I know I'm going to need the fruit to... Wait, is that shadow? Oh, that's right, there's a coin up there. Forgot all about that. Might as well go grab that, what the heck. Wait, did I talk to you? I don't think I talked to you. Don't worry, he's okay. He's trapped in this practically indestructible egg. And there's another coin? There's more fruits. And I think in order to get this coin, you gotta do like a rolling charge jump thingy by pressing the R button and then jumping. Like this! Yeah! That was awesome. Now let's free the elder. Let the sun shine in! And that's how you get morning back. With the crow of the chicken. Let's talk to the elder. You're welcome! I kind of heard that from a bunch of people. From the very, very beginning of the level. And that's the plot of the game, basically. Save the elders, bring morning back to the lands. There's quite a lot of stuff to collect in this game, including a lot of critters to hatch from eggs. And there we go. They're kind of like Mario 64 stars in a way, in that you gotta collect them all. Gotta catch them all, or gotta collect them all. And boop.
Good morning.
There's a slight audio glitch there. You hear that? That's weird. I don't know why I did that. It sounded like my Wii was really working hard to make that cutscene happen anyway. So maybe that was my Wii's issue or something like that. Yeah, whatever. Yes! I'll do one more level because that one took so long. Mission 2! Defeat Iragecko! That's a boss level. Loading. Gotta climb up to the top to this portal. Indeed! You just broke the whole flow. Yeah, it really sounds like my Wii is working hard here for some reason. Maybe I should eject the disc and then put it back in just for a sec here. Well, after this, thingy ends. Okay, hold on a sec. Hold on! I'm putting that disc back in. I'm not sure it actually matters because it already loaded the level. Should we start the song? I don't know what the heck's going on here. You're the one that's hearing it too. I'm directly recording this gameplay, dang it. Alright, so I got another special egg here, and I'm going to go on this track. Woohoo! Sort of like a pinball track, actually. I don't know how he doesn't get hurt as he's being scraped along the sides of the railings, but we probably shouldn't question that too much. Barrel cannons that aren't actually barrels! I would like to squish these critters off, if at all possible. I don't know what the heck is inside the this green marking egg here. I guess we will soon find out! Also break some crates. I think this is a... Yep! Gotta collect things as I go down. Oh god, on a coin! Oh, I missed it! Curses! Off the thorn walls. I do not feel like going back and getting that coin. Wow, that was complete ownage. Now, what's inside this? Oh, this gives you the power of wind. I remember. If you grab another egg and then fling it forward, see that? It infuses the power into the... Whoops! Into the egg. Come on, respawn. I would like another eggy. I know they respawn from here. There we go. Don't worry, that bridge won't break. It only sounds like it's gonna break. They do that just to scare you. And I'm looking for something. I forgot what I'm looking for here, but something to open that cage. Maybe I have to kill all the enemies. Oh, I completely missed most of them. I guess I was just kill all the enemies. Ah, that sounds good to me. But I remember needing a critter's power to get something. Maybe it's for something later on in the level or something like that. Do you have to say anything about the thing that I'm looking for? Well, of course it did, because that's the thing that was shown right at the beginning. And here's another barrel cannon-like thing. Aim yourself with the arrow and press the A button to fling yourself out of it. Well, you don't actually aim yourself with the arrow, it's automatically turning on its own. Alright, gotta kill all the enemies! Oh, this is where I needed something. I need a water critter. And it's in a blue egg somewhere. Not these white and blue spotted ones. I just got another coin. Oop. Wait, what am I doing that for? It's not ready to hatch. Where was that blue egg that I'm looking for? It's around here somewhere, inside of crates. Oh, there it is. Those cats are not strong whatsoever. You got a nice large egg on your side. That gave me absolutely nothing. Wow. That was not worth hatching that egg. Well, now I need some more food to feed my egg. It's growing even before it's a baby. Now I know I can't just like roll the egg at... Oh, food respawns? Well, that helps. Alright, that's good enough. Awesome sauce. Now let's douse this flame. Oh, forgot to touch him. My bad. Boop. And now I need another egg to be able to press Z switch, which will open the cage. And boop. Oh, how did I miss that? I thought those things were like crackly. Automatic or something like that. Well, it looks like I'm right near the end of the level. And boop! Boop! In the portal we go! Gotta leave your egg behind though. For some reason. I guess it's to sort of make sure you don't have too many overpowered power-ups before you, you know, go into the boss or something like that. Bring it on, you're a gecko! So he's inside that grass. We need an egg. We can't do anything without an egg. And there he is actually right there, but he's a lot smaller than how he looked. That's how he sort of camouflages himself. Sort of... Yeah, find him like that, and then just keep attacking him with the egg. Eventually he's gonna get up, and you wanna leave. He's gonna spew water to replenish the grass that I am flattening here, which makes it easier for him to hide. And he's trying to attack me, but he's not doing a very good job of it. You should probably power up your egg as well, just so if you can do more damage to him. Very nice boss setting here, I have to say, in the swampy area. I'm going to blow up that egg just for the fun of it. Where is he? I forgot how to switch the camera above me, because that would definitely be very helpful. Oop, can't attack him now. Come on, get back in the grass so I can start attacking. Well... You know, hiding in the grass. Come on, you can do it. Alright, now I'm gonna wait for him to go back into small mode. Oh, where'd he go? Oh, there we go. He sort of teleported on me there. Oh! I forgot he does that. Dang, shoot the whoops. Woo! Just keep moving. Don't let him get a lock on. I guess he just moves to a random spot in the battle arena. Oh, come on! You got a sliver of health left? Come on! Get back in small mode. Oh, as you can see, the bigger your egg is, the more the grass blades you flatten. It's sort of like those crop circles things that people make. Pretty clever concept, actually. And the boss was formed by many, many crows, as you can see. And that is all I'm going to be doing in this random gameplay video. I hope you enjoyed. Wait, actually, I'm gonna hatch this egg. Let's see if it has anything inside for me. Nothing! Okay. Completely worthless eggs. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. Well, I guess they're not completely useless because, you know, if they manage to kill enemies in the boss and whatnot. But I mean in terms of what's inside of them.